And I thought that my mother was consumed by greed. I thought that she forgot how it is to feel human, Toby. I was wrong.
Even your mother committed a lot of mistakes. Now you know that she's always loved you until the end. She is still your mother, Sophia. And most of all, she sacrificed her own life in order to save yours.
I don't know what's happening to it anymore. Not long ago, I had a good life. I was studying. My family was peaceful. I was happy. But look at it now. My mother is gone. My brother Miguel and my sister Catherine are fighting for their lives. Toby, they might die. And then I will be left all alone.
Shh. It's okay. Sophia, you are not alone. I'll be here for you. I'll always be here for you. I'll never let anything bad happen to you.
The doctor told me that you need to fight this if you want to stay alive. You can do that, right? I know you can do this. You're strong. Miguel. Miguel, I'm going to promise you. I won't pick fights with you again. I'll never bother you about anything again, I promise. I just want you to stay alive. I'll do anything. Miguel, I'll even set you free. Anything just to have you live again. I'll give you anything you ask for, anything at all. I will let you be with Catherine. If that's what it takes, Miguel, I'll give it to you. Miguel, I will do anything. That's how much I love you. I'm willing to do anything for you. Anything to have you here again. That's all I want and need from you.
Are there any updates on the heart transplant list? How's my sister doing?
She's third on the list.
What's taking so long? She's already running out of time.
The problem is, we still have to wait for someone to die who has a healthy heart to give. And even then, we still have to run some tests to see if it's viable and if the heart is a match.
Doctor, isn't there anything else we can do about this?
All we can do is wait and hope for a healthy heart for Catherine.
And by the way, Mr. Torralba, these are the results of the test that the congressman had with us. Please tell your brother that he has a healthy heart and he is a perfect match for Catherine de la Rea. Unfortunately, unlike with liver transplants, We can't have live heart donors. Please excuse us.
Diazepam, 5 milligrams. Now, check her vital signs.
I don't think I can take it if Miguel and Catherine pass away. I'm going to be left with no family if that happens.
Don't worry about it, Sophia. None of your siblings are going to die.
How do you know that?
I just do. They're not going to die.
I'll do anything, Catherine. I'll go through this for you. I don't care if I die. I just want you to be alive. Here we go. I just hope I'm not too late to save Catherine.
Thanks for helping us. Miguel? Miguel? Hey, Scarlett, I think Miguel's awake. Miguel?
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 Miguel? Miguel? Sophia, go and call the doctor, hurry! Miguel! Miguel! I'm right here.
Uh.
Sophia, what's going on with Catherine now?
The doctor told me that her condition is getting worse. And if she doesn't get a heart transplant within 36 hours, she might.
We might just lose Catherine altogether.
Nurse, how long have I been here?
Almost a week now, sir. But it looks like you've made a huge improvement, and we've all heard that you'll be moved to a regular room.
And Catherine DeLorea, how is she doing?
She's still in critical condition at the moment, sir. We still don't have a donor for her planned heart transplant. We actually thought you would become the donor, but you've improved so much, sir. You'll be well enough to check out here soon.
Catherine and I are a match.
That's right. I'll go ahead, sir.
Scarlet, you really shouldn't have bothered to come here. What if you pick up some contagious disease? Think about the baby.
Miguel, I'll be all right. Don't worry about me too much. The baby is going to be okay. Nothing's going to happen to the baby. It's very healthy. He's just like his father, isn't he?
You really should get some rest, you know. Go on. I'll be okay right here.
I was really on my way home anyway. I was really planning to be here early tomorrow morning so I can supervise everything with the room you'll be moving into. I'll be going ahead, okay? I hope you feel better soon. I'll see you tomorrow, okay?
Okay. Scarlet? Please take good care of yourself, okay? Take care of our baby. What about you? Aren't you going to get some sleep?
I will in a while, Miguel.
Hey, why are you crying? You know I can't stand it when I see you cry. Come on.
I'm just really worried about Catherine. They told me she's deteriorating fast. She needs a new heart right away, but they still haven't found a donor for her.
Don't worry about it, Sophia. I'm sure that a heart donor will come. I'm sure of it. You just have to believe. Now go on. I need to get some rest now.
What is it, Miguel? Do you feel something? Do you want me to call the doctor?
No. I feel just fine. Just a little tired. Go on. You have to go get some sleep.
Okay. I love you, Miguel.
I love you too.
Oh, this is great. Okay, tomorrow, I'm going to make sure that I'm in the hospital bright and early. I'm going there to clean and decorate the room that Miguel is moving into. And then I'm going to fill it with cheerful decor so he won't feel like he's in a hospital. I don't want him to feel depressed because he has to stay in such a gloomy
place. I'm sure that would cheer him up. And then we can also put up some funny decorations around. He likes having those.
Okay, and then I will make sure that I will have all of his favorite dishes with me. I'll even cook myself. Did the nurses tell you if he can eat regular food?
Oh, I don't think so. I mean, they haven't taken him out of his liquid diet yet.
Whatever, it doesn't matter. Maybe I can just osterize the steak, then maybe that won't be so bad. I can feed him that. It's steak, but in liquid form. That's okay, right?
Scarlett, I doubt it, but that's okay. We can have the steak all to ourselves.
What about Miguel? Oh, and I was also thinking that maybe I can bring a lot of DVDs for him, and maybe we can even bring a DVD player, right? So he can spend time watching movies, so he won't ever get bored. You know how your brother can be.
Scarlett, I can't believe you're this excited about tomorrow.
Is it really that obvious? You know how excited I can get.
No, not at all.
I really want to make sure he has a great time in that room.
Good morning, Sleeping Beauty.
What happened to your head? Oh.
That's a long story. I'll tell you about it some other time.
To me, how come my body feels so painful?
You were shot. You, just went through a heart transplant.
You mean to tell me that I now have a new heart?
Yes.
Well, I guess it was due for a replacement. It's gone through so much already. But who? Who donated this heart to me? Raphael, maybe you can help me. I want to be able to thank the family of the person who donated their heart just for me. What is it? What is it?
It's Miguel. That's Miguel's heart. He died and gave it to you.
I just came here to thank you for that wonderful gift that you have given me. I don't think I've received anything so important. And I promise you that I'm going to take care of it. I won't let anything happen to it. And you know that you have always been someone who is important to me. You mean so much to me. And no matter where you are right now, even though we will never see each other again, I feel as though we will never be apart. Because you are always here with me. You will always be here, Miguel. I will never, ever forget you. Thank you. Thank you.
Catherine, I just want to talk to you about our wedding. We never really got to talk about it when we were in the hospital because I didn't think that we would be. Anyway, why don't we go to the city hall? We can just get married there, you know?
Would it be all right if we don't talk about this now?
Why is that?
I've just had so many things on my mind, and I have a lot of stuff to take care of.
What is it? Don't you love me anymore?
You know that I've been with many other men. But I have never loved anyone like this before. I love you, Raphael. It's always been you. But you see now, I don't know if I can go back to that feeling again. I feel like I'd be betraying Miguel after everything he's done for me.
Catherine, you know that Miguel gave his heart up for you so that he could give you a new life. And I'm sure that he would have wanted us to be together. He sacrificed so much to keep us together.
I don't know. I really don't know, Rafael. I don't know what to say. Maybe I just need some time alone. I just need some time to think things over. I'm sorry.
What?
Sir?
Neil.
Madam Catherine was just here for you, but she left right away.
Did she say when she's coming back?
Oh, no, sir. But then she left this letter for you.
Thank you, Neil.
Okay, sir.
I love you, Rafael. And you're the only man I will ever love. But instead of making you happy, I always end up hurting your feelings. Even though I never mean it, it seems that is all I ever do. I almost ruined your reputation. And I put your life in danger so many times already. I don't deserve to be with you, Rafael. Maybe what your mother said was right. You should never be with me. But I love you so much, Rafael. And I just can't let your life be ruined by staying with you. That's why I'm letting you go. I don't deserve your love. Goodbye, Rafael.
Catherine? Catherine! Hello? Hello, Rafael? I can't find Catherine here. I have no idea where she could be. Where is that woman?
Hello? Catherine? 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 Dear Sophia, I'm sorry I wasn't able to say goodbye. But I decided that I can say goodbye to you through this letter. I just thought that if I tell you where I'm planning to go, you would try to stop me. Then I won't be able to leave at all. Sophia, I just need to do this right now. I know that I've made so many mistakes. I've hurt so many people. That's why I feel that I need to get away. To be able to find myself, I need to do something to make up for the things I've done. And I don't know when I can come back. But always remember one thing.
no matter where I am. You will always be in my heart. I love you, Sophia. Catherine. Catherine disappeared from our lives after I read that letter. We all tried looking for her everywhere, but we couldn't find her. And Luella and I were left to take care of the plantation. We both made a promise to each other that we will make Amadesto flourish again, just like before. Because that's what Catherine would have wanted. And that's what Aura would want too.
Hey! Wow, flowers.
Hello there.
Thank you. These are beautiful. Should I give him a kiss?
We've all moved on since then, and a lot of things have happened to us through the years.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back our new president. Scarlett Castillejos.
Hello.
Hi, Bruno.
Hi. Hey, maybe I can help. If you can do this, you're going to earn a lot from it. Millions. This is Marco's way of expressing his thanks for your help.
Wow.
Enjoy.
All right.
Wow, that looks good. That looks really good.
Well, you should wait for the next.
Good job. Everybody, come here. Take a look. Ouch.
Oh. Serves you right for talking too much.
Ouch, I stepped in mud. Stop it.
Are you okay? Something. Let me help you. Next time, take it easy, okay?
Stop it.
We're so cute together.
We really had a great harvest this year, and we owe it all to our hardworking people. I'm hoping that things will always be this great.
I guess it really made a big difference when you offered them incentives. They worked harder because they had a share of the profits. And that's why everybody's really happy.
This is what Aura always dreamed about. And this is what Catherine would have wanted.
And you made it all come true just for both of them. And you know what? It's not just the people in your farm who are really happy right now. I'm happy too. That's because you'll be staying in the city with me.
You are so corny.
Oh, really? But you still love me anyway. Be nice, or else I probably won't give you my gift.
Hey, that's not fair.
Don't expect too much, okay? I just got it from a cheap store. Now close your eyes.
What's this about? Okay. Was that what your gift was?
Will you just wait?
Hmm. What is this? What's all the secrecy about, Toby? Are you sure I'm going to like this gift?
Just go and pick one.
This one.
Wrong one.
That one, then.
Sophia, will you marry me?
Yes. We've all learned to move on. And so many things have happened to us this past few years. But during all those years, we didn't hear a single word from Catherine.
I'm sure it was a misunderstanding. It was one of the good guys.
Oh, here he comes. He even
gave us that raise. Oh.
We're all going to miss Congressman.
Thank you. Thank you for the banner. Thank you.
Thank you for everything.
I'm going to miss all of you,
thank
too.
Thank you so much for sir, everything, sir.
I've already placed your things inside the car.
Thank you, Neil. By the way, don't forget to clean up the whole office, okay? I want the next congressman to enjoy this place.
It's really a shame, sir, that you didn't try to run for another term here. I'm very sure you would have won again.
This is the end of me, Neil. I don't believe politics is for me. And I know there are other ways of helping out people here in our country.
What now, sir? Are you going to go back to being a lawyer?
I think that's the best option for me right now. And I'm also planning to form a charitable foundation. And Neil, Jeff,
mm-hmm.
I will always want volunteers. I need volunteers.
Anytime, sir.
Thank you. Well, it's time to go. I'll go ahead.
All right, sir.
Thanks again. I appreciate
it.
I'll see you around, okay? Thank you. I'll go now.
All going to miss you.
Thank you for the help.
Just too bad. So nice politicians go.
Here you go. Oh, how is the patient? Can you give me that? Make sure it's evenly distributed, okay? Oh, hello. Do we need more food here? Okay.
Let me have one of that.
Madam, here, this is for you. Take it.
Say thank you.
Here you go. Let's go over there.
Thank you.
We can play there.
Do they have medicine?
We have a lot more medicine.
Oh, yes.
We should go. A vacation in the province would be good. I noticed these past few days that it looks like you have been very cold and distant to Raphael.
But I can make that for you.
Oh, that's right, I forgot.
We can save money and buy flowers.
Are you happy?
Grandmother.
Are you happy, Catherine?
Grandmother, are you proud of me? I've been helping so many people here, and I've made them
very happy. I've taught them how to read, to write, and I'm also trying my very best to make sure that I can help them improve their lives.
But then, Catherine, while you are doing all of that, you've forgotten about yourself. How are you ever going to be happy if there's an empty space in your heart?
You know, there is only one man who can fill this void, Grandmother. But I know that I don't deserve to be with him at all.
I know how hard it is to forgive the people who've done us wrong. But it's so much harder to forgive ourselves for our mistakes. But I hope that you will learn to do that for yourself. I see that as the only way for you to ever find happiness. I want you to be happy.
Catherine, are you all right? You seem very tired these past few days.
I'm all right. I'm going to be just fine.
Why don't you stretch for a bit? Are you all right? Your mind seems so far away. You've been with us for such a long time, but I've never heard you say anything about your life before.
My life before this place? It's not worth talking about. It was boring. So when are you due to give birth? Have you already thought of a name?
Oh, I haven't done that. Do you have any suggestions for me?
Oh, that one's pretty easy. If you want your child to grow up and be responsible and handsome, then Raphael is what you should name your child.
Raphael. Oh, hold on. There's someone here who's been asking for you.
Who is it?
There he is. I'll leave you two alone.
Sa dinami-dami ng aking minahal, panandalian lamang at ilalang nagtagal. Iisa pa lamang ang binabalikan, alaala ng kahapon pinabayaan. Sa dinami-dami ng aking nakapiling, kung sino-sino ang umibig sa akin, isa pa lamang ang inaasang-asang, ang nakalipas di maaring balikan.
Catherine, I'm so glad that I finally found you.
I feel the same way. I was finally able to find myself. And now I'm finally ready.
When you love somebody, it doesn't matter if you're right or wrong.
It doesn't matter who gives or who receives. There is no victory. There is no defeat. What really matters is that you loved someone. What really matters is that I love him. I really love him.